Instead of trying to figure out what's the best place to put the money, you just understand that there are endless places to put it, and one place is as good as another, and it doesn't really matter which place it is, because that wasn't the point anyway. The point wasn't to find the most needy place and put your money there. The point was to have a reason for money to flow through you toward something that made you feel good while it was flowing through you. You can't find enough charities to fix. And if you get on that bandwagon, you'll go crazy, because the charities will come out of the woodwork and they'll say, give it to me, give it to me, give it to me, give it to me. And before you know it, you will feel shortage because not enough money can flow through the vortex called you and your group to satisfy all of those that will be saying, give it to me, give it to me. And then you want to say, wait, I don't give it to you because you need it. I give it to you because it felt good to give it to you. But now it doesn't feel so good to give it to you. Jerry and Esther met a wonderful girl in a restaurant in California a while back, and they could tell she was from another country. She had a delightful accent, and as they visited with her, she was from a part of Russia, and they liked her so much. They liked her sweetness. They liked her trying. They liked how much she wanted to do a good job at what she was doing. And so Esther had a purse full of money that she had been carrying around from one of the workshops, and as she was writing the amount for the tip, she said to Jerry, what do you think about just giving her this envelope? And Jerry said, I think it's a good idea. He didn't even ask how much was in it. It didn't matter to either one of them. There was a lot of money in it, thousands of dollars in it. And so the little girl brought the check, and Esther put some money on as a tip because she didn't want her employer to think that the girl had not given them good service. And then Esther just said, we'd like you to have this too. And she said, thank you very much. And she went back into the kitchen, and then they heard dishes breaking. And she comes back to the table, and she is beside herself with appreciation. And then she begins to tell them how much she needed this money. And Esther said, well, in that case, give it back. Teasing. And Esther said, we didn't give this money to you because you need money. We gave this money to you because you just inspired it from us. Your freshness, your aliveness, your happy with lifeness, your looking for where you're going, you just evoked it from us. We don't give it to you because you need it. And later they got an email, and it said, I told my friend this morning that something wonderful was going to happen to me. I didn't know where or when or how or what. I just told my friend I could feel that something wonderful was going to happen to me. And so there that was in her vibration. And there Jerry and Esther are driving around with a purse full of money, trying to decide where they're going to have lunch. Now, they had not decided that they were going to go there for lunch. In fact, they were on their way someplace else for lunch, someplace that they always go, that they love to go, on the water. And as they came around the corner off the freeway entrance, Jerry said, oh, look, there's that place I've been wondering about. What do you think about going there for lunch? And it was such an odd time of the day. There was not even a car in the parking lot. And Esther said, it may not even be open. Esther was sort of wanting to continue the path that they were upon. And Jerry said, I really want to see this place. Let's park and at least check it out. And so Esther said, well, I'll just drive up and you go in and see if there's anybody in there. And if there is, wave me in and I'll come. So Jerry went in, the door was open, and he waved Esther in and she parked. And in they are. Can you feel how this girl and her alignment in it was alignment, her place of expecting something good to happen to her. So the universe knows everything. The universe knows there she is expecting something wonderful to happen, and there is somebody who has the ability to make something wonderful happen, and everybody just gets the right cue at the right time in order to end up in the right place. In other words, don't you think that's a lovely path that you're living on? Don't you think it's a wonderful thing? And don't you understand that it isn't about the result? In other words, it isn't about making something happen. It's just getting in on the joy of the journey.